Hello friends, a very good afternoon for today. My best wishes to all of you, and I want to express my best wishes for the December, the last year of 2019, and pray that the 2020 comes to everybody's life in the one of the best year in the life, with peace, progress and health and all these things. Today I want to present to you on the best practice, regular practice which I have missed most of it in my life or in my lifetime. So that is the topic I want to present you. After that I missed in my life fitness, then a talk on fitness, then divine quest, all these things I have discussed. Now this is also regular practice, another aspect of every human being. Today I will present to you, to my friends only, and it is also relevant across all, and also for younger generation of small kids or tiny age and ripe age also. And it is relevant for all ages, not only, but also better late than ever. Even it is applicable to the very very ripe age like that of me. Now coming back to our topic, what is the this regular practice means? Regular practice is that when we get up and go to toilet and finish our daily chore, like going to toilet and brushing our teeth and shaving, then taking bath and all these things. Many people used to go for a morning walk or after getting actually doing some few meditation and other things. So those things happen, additional things that, and other people are get busy when the business service life, they used to be busy, finish their daily chore, and regularly they visit to office or business concern and complete the job. My point is that you do the daily things, like timely regular practice of having your lunch, dinner, breakfast and evening snacks and other things, all these things, and also having actually a few exercises, daily exercises and other things, then yoga if possible you are doing this thing, regular practice. Those things are of everyday human life nowadays. I need not actually explain all these things. If you are doing this thing, fine. If you are not doing this thing, very very relevant as far as my point is concerned, my point of presentation is concerned. Are you getting up in the early morning or 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock or 10 o'clock like that? No. This is extremely bad. Regular practice should be getting up early morning just when sun rises. That means when the dark getting dispelled and lighted skies are there, but sunrise has not yet taken place. It is the dusk and dawn. Both are the very very vital moment where actually you have to finish your job regularly. And at the time of dawn, say 4:30, 5 o'clock, some places 6, 7, like that. It depends upon. We get up. We have to get up and go to, immediately you get up. I have also given a talk on that, having the practice of water, taking water into your body system, regular practice. So that practice I never took, but read it on Facebook, and other informations also I collected this thing. Once I got interested, it checks and filter your system all the toxic things we are taking daily habit nowadays. Whatever you are taking, only toxins. When I was born at 1951, so in mid 60s and 70s, actually you see the food was not that toxic at that time. But today most of the oil, then fat, and the foods the supplied are not actually with insecticides and other things. So you cannot remove them. And all these things are very, very toxic. And if you drink a lot of water, then regular practice of like taking lot of water, then it will definitely rectify your system and be able to remove these toxic elements of your body through urine or perspiration, like that. Early morning when you get up, you take actually two slightly warm, not at all warm is advisable, and also in the summer season, avoid this. But except summer, that in say April, May, June, July, once rain comes, August, September rain comes, then you can start it again. And this 2 glass of warm water, best will be lemon. I am not taking, but if you take lemon, it is fine, and pinch of salt. 2 glass of water, if you take, then if you want to go to toilet, then you can go to toilet regularly, brush your teeth. If you are young enough, then take your bath. After shaving, if you are grown up, take your beard. And best is to shave yourself. Few people don't shave it. It is up to your liking. I am not insisting, but best is if you shave, good. Then regularly walking in the morning is very, very essential. When I was 13, 14 years of age, I used to go to seashore in Puri, because we are a resident of Puri town, and I used to go by a cycle to Puri sea beach. It is a very, very nice place to run along the sea beach. And I used to run from Sargodar to Digavarani Khunti or Circuit House. Nowadays the Circuit House has been transferred to somewhere else. But at earlier, there is a Gandhi Smarak, and till that time distance, I used to move and run. After that, we walk some time, at least 1 hour or something like that. Then we go do some physical exercises in Jatiya Vyayam Kreda Parishad, and after that we used to go to a pond near our house, Jagaghara, and there we put a heavy oil on our body and jump into the water and take bath. Nowadays you can take, actually for older people, you can have slightly warm water and wash yourself. It is fine. Then after taking your bath and everything, getting fresh, you can have a morning walk in an empty stomach. Slightly, if you feel gastritis problem or something like an ulcer and all the things, you can take some biscuits, then walk. Walking is a very, very essential ingredient of your stress factor and also body. You see, I am not give you on health tips on these things. But thing is that it is what my point is, my present topic of the presentation is that regular practice that I missed and repent nowadays. And let actually others should not miss this thing. They should practice as much as possible. My point is that once you finish this thing and go to morning work and coming back and finish your breakfast and you get ready for to going offices or going to school, colleges and whatever it may be, and regularly be attentive to your job if you are in office, regularly attentive to your school and colleges if you are a student. Remember, if you are a student, my advice is that, here comes, it is not health tips. My advice is that refrain from gossiping, refrain from mixing with many, many students. Your objective is not to get to friends, and your objective is not to pass your time in gossip, in canteen, or nearby pan shop, beetle shop, smoking, talking, like that passing away. But when the vital aspect of study, going to school and colleges, will be missed. When the teacher comes, you should be on the first bench. If the first bench is full, then second bench. Like that way, you should come first and occupy the first seat and see right attentively what he is telling, whether you like it, whether you dislike, but write in your notebook. I passed only with this principle, regular practice in engineering colleges, first class honors distinction, only because of this. My class note was enough to secure me first class honors. You can't believe it happened. And also in IIT, same thing happened. I used to sit in the first class, first seat, and I used to sit very attentively and write down whatever the teacher is saying, and also refer only to the books literally, and print it in examination paper and get actually the same examiner, same teacher in IIT who teaches, the same teacher will put the question and the same teacher will evaluate. This is the beauty of IIT. But the most difficult aspect is that today he has taught you something. Every night I request all students, that night must be that topic should be completed. It should not be spilled over. Today my uncle has come, today my friends has come, I had certain urgent other appointments. No. If you are a student, today if you have gone anywhere else in the evening, coming at 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock, sit down for an entire evening. At the age of 70, it is not advisable for me. But at the age of 14, at the age of 24, at the age of 32, I used to pass a entire night in IIT till the morning. Then attend the colleges at 8 o'clock. So, that is the thing, is that today's chapter you have to finish. So that in IIT, this actually gave me great opportunity to get actually A+ CGPA. Cumulative grade point average, very, very 84%, so to say, percentile 8.43 CGPA. It happened only because today's chapter, whatever has been taught, I will complete that entire night sitting through my notebook and referring to books or reference manuals, whatever I have given to me, I will go through this thing, memorize this thing, write down at least few pages, then sleep. If time is available, I will sleep. But tomorrow, what happens with the beauty of that IIT is that class teacher comes, a particularly there are so many classes, one class teacher comes and they at random test you. It may be 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, like that in a month. So, and whatever they will test, they will simply distribute one page of paper to each of the student, and that will be given to you. And what will happen? You have to, a blackboard, there will be a question mark, question number, and you have to answer it. The first person who will answer and submit this, you will get 10 out of 10, if it is correct. If it is wrong, zero. No mercy. IIT, there is no mercy. If you committed wrong, zero. As much as you are right, don't try to bluff. Point is that. And second thing is that, who is the second? He will get 9. Who is the third? He will get 9 point, like that, point wise. And actually, like that, if 4 class tests, your mark is A. So that month you will get this thing. And every semester there is an examination. Suppose you could not attend the examination, test examination, and what will happen? That, if that will happen, what happens? The class teacher exempt you from your examination. Are you surprised? Exempt you from this examination on the basis of your class test. If the cumulative 6 classes average test cumulative grade point, average cumulative grade point is A, you are getting A. If it is A plus, 10 out of 10, then A plus. If it is B plus, B plus, like that it goes on. So regularity of study, I have given an example of my BSc honors and engineering and also M.Tech in computer science in IIT, and how I succeeded only because of this. Very, looks very small, but it is very, very thing. Number one, few friends. Choose 2 or 3 friends in your lifetime who give you maximum benefit to you in studies, who are brilliant, who talks less, who are very point-wise brief, and also never bluff or gossip. And intoxication, other aspect, I will come back. Wait. I am talking now about your caricature and ethics in college and student life, and as an officer in service life. Service life, same thing I prefer. I used to stay 10 to 8, morning 10 o'clock, to, and sometimes even 9 o'clock, to, at the evening period, 9 o'clock, 12 hours, I used to work. Very, very difficult time, and at that time it happens, you know, many visitors used to come, many people come for work, and other people come for gossip. I never entertain them. Occasionally we entertain guests because we are a service holder, we have to entertain. But thing is that when guests come for work, that is the highest preference in my life. I cannot do my personal work and serve this thing. And completing your job on that day. Today the chief secretary wants something is to be cleared by me or posted by me, I will definitely post it on that day itself. Not that I will keep and after 1 month he will pursue after me that what I have done, and he found that I have not done. Very, and give a, what will crucify me? No, nothing. Only thing is that he will give a very bad marker, quite lazy fellow, untrustworthy. But this is not ethics of life. Ethics is that you should be very prompt and precise and correct answer, and whatever is given by the assembly, whatever is given by the secretaries, whatever department of one department, whatever is given by your as far as your job is concerned, as a service holder and a business, and if you are a business person, same thing, regularity, preciseness, point-wise, if you will involve yourself on unnecessary things, it is a regular practice. It is one night, you cannot achieve anything. My point is, I am not deviating from the main point. My point is the regularity of practice. Today you do it, you think that you have utilized your time in the best way possible, from 9 to 9, then definitely try to achieve that regularity from 9 to 9 throughout your life. When a student, same thing. When a service life, same thing. When a retired life also, same thing. You fix your jobs on the early morning, what you do want to do. At 10 o'clock to 12 o'clock, what you want to do. At 12 o'clock, you have to get your lunch at 12:30 or 1 o'clock. Okay, I'll definitely at 1 o'clock, I'll take my lunch. Then after that, you must sleep for 2 hours. Okay, you sleep for 2 hours. Not that few friends come and will play cards. No, I cannot go. Many people get wayward. But the harm of going, someone said that, okay, you will get illness. Oh, okay, illness, I will go away. Like that, this sort of discussion doesn't mean. Disciplined life is the best life of a human being. You see, simple watch Gandhiji, our father of the nation, put on our belt, as a belt, a round clock, round watch, including stopwatch facility also. And entire life he moved entire nation round the clock along with his time. It will not deviate. So, an ordinary person as a also, we can achieve our timely things as a regular practice. I have missed, my topic is that regular practice I miss the most in my lifetime. I am saying this much, but thing is that never maintained that. I now at this ripe age think that if I would have done this thing regularly, then I would have definitely done much better. Okay, I had been rewarded properly in my engineering college. I have been rewarded by IIT in my post-graduation level, but my service life I was not regular for my taking lunch. Today it is 12, next day it will be 2 o'clock, next day it will be 4 o'clock, there is no time, work. What happened? I got 2 ulcers. Evening 9 o'clock you have to get to sleep. Even if you are a younger person, still then you should sleep. Night duty you have. I was an engineer in Talcher Thermal. So most of the guys, they sleep in the control room. You hang me. They see that the entire system is running fine and put one guy alerted and the rest of the people will sleep. If anything goes at fault, then he will push other people to get up and try to solve the problem. Otherwise, everybody will sleep in the night time, 9 o'clock to early morning, 6 o'clock, all will sleep. But myself, every hour I take a glass of water and if possible one cigarette, if it is available, then entire night wake up and see the watchful entire dashboards of the monitoring system, control and monitoring system of 110 megawatt, 4 generator sets. What happened? After 3 months, one day, I vomited whatever I took in the night at my dinner, everything I vomited, and I saw that even that chapatis and other thing, curries and that I have taken, it came out as such, nothing, no digestion. Indigestion took place. And when the chest burning started at the age of 40, and when I came to Cuttack, I found out that there was a duodenal ulcer. Now, guys, my point is that if I have neglected, I got this punishment. If I would have very, very particular as far as my sleeping is concerned, okay, one day, one night, night job, okay, I'll do. But thing is that I'll sleep, I'll see, watch, and take some rest, and daytime, entire day, I'll give rest to my body. No. Again, early morning, I'll come back to the plant and sit and take up my job. And if I am interested to work, who will deny you? You go and work. And ultimately, who suffered? Myself only. Like that. Many people go to their home and sleep in time. Okay, today night shift I have completed. Okay, I'll 4 hours or 5 hours, I'll sleep in the early morning. Come back and finish my daily core and have some lunch and other thing, then sleep. I miss that. Then coming back, another vital aspect, regular practice of intoxication. You may hang me. I have been trapped also to some extent, that I used to take Beatles from my BSc age when I was, say, 22, 23 of age. After that, I used to take Beatles, say, first for 10 or 15, like that, and it continued up to 2004, 5, like that. Almost 3 decades of my 10-15 Beatles daily. What happened? Now 4 or 5 teeth gone. And that is not only that. Acidity, jarda, and other things are there. Then some cigarette. But a very short time. Actually, I had been very severely ragged in engineering college. One guy severely ragged me, giving a one Charminar cigarette, forced me to smoke. I didn't smoke. Coming from home, actually very innocent guy, I never smoked. I said, what is that? No, that is a cigarette. Oh, that is a cigarette. You came after BSc and you do not know what is a cigarette. Bloody fellow. I do not know, I never touch this thing, I do not know even how to taste it and other things. Now you smoke. So he popped and showed me that you do this with Charminar. I coughed, so difficult. Tears are coming from my eyes. But they were enjoying, clapping. I was so much angry, he happens to be from my own place. Just 2 years senior. That fellow was enjoying my pain and misery. I was so angry. And when I reached second year, I smoked before him. One day he was at the time final year student. And he told, Mr. Mishra, you are smoking. You couldn't smoke even a single cigarette. I forced you one packet of cigarette, 10 cigarettes, and now you are regularly smoking. I have marked. I go, so what? It is your father's money. Only to beat him in my anger that you have ragged me so severely. Now I teach you a lesson. Actually, I have not teach him a lesson, but only I betrayed myself. Never get angry. Anger is a device that will burn yourself within. We are actually fools. Whoever make you get angry, If you, I ever at any point of time I become angry, then only thing is that I am damaging my body only and my psychology also. Tension will come, stress will come, and other things will come, and I'll lose my coolness and calmness. So that is the point. Is a bad habit, except that I didn't have any, but other people are having. Intoxication is taking wine. Whoever is taking wine, once it happened that one of my daughter-in-law asked me that, Nana, have you ever taken liquor? Uncle, yes. Why should I feel shy or tell lies to you? I am an engineer. Once in a party in Talcher Thermal, it happened. I took a glass of a beer glass of beer, and I couldn't. I just vomited everything. It was not acceptable to my body. So I whatever I took in that dinner, actually vomited entire in my own residence and didn't tell anybody. After that, I never. Intoxication, whether it is a cigarette, whether it is a pouch, jarda pouch, whether it is a beetle, whether it is a liquor, and upward further, I will not talk even. You know very well what I am meaning to that. But certainly accepting death. Regular practice means is such a thing. Once you are habituated in smoking, come half an hour after, you will feel actually another cigarette. Any type of a tension, you feel worried, my cigarette, I'll smoke. Or any type of leisure you have relaxed, feeling relaxed, take a beetle. And evening come morning, come lunch, and I saw that people who used to visit and have their drinking habit. There is no daytime even for few people, all the time drinking. And they pretend that drinking is also healthy. Very in Facebook also I have seen that the beer is also ill. No, sir. If you want, take actually green tea, liquor. A cup of tea you can take, and not very hot, warm tea, just cup, it will give lot of energy to you. But I suggest that if you can capable, but not actually red label tea, but green tea. You take that means the tea leaf that is being plucked and being sold, there are very costly, but if you take this thing, the liquor is very, very healthy. And it removes cancer also. And ilachi, you can take those things, you can just if you had. So you can avoid these types of regular practices. So this is another aspect is that intoxication, one thing, regular practice of daily habits. These two aspects I wanted to tell you. Now what I have not told, now I will explain that, is it these things that I have missed the most? No. I have missed the most that I was not aware of at all. At the fag end of my life, I found that there are many young guys who are awakened, who are doing regular practice like reading books. Sir, are you reading ever books? Which books? Filthy books or good novels in English or Oriya or Hindi or any other languages that you know there, you have you ever read? Because a writer who writes a book, he or she passes a lifetime of taking this entire society under microscope and analyzing and portraying you as a story to your mind. And that will enlighten you much bigger canvas that you can see what is this world is that, even if you have not met that, but you can see and observe by reading. Mere knowledge will be there. Book is that I have missed, that I used to read some books, spiritual books also I used to read, some novels also I have read, some crime stories I have read like James Bond and Frederick Forsyth and other things are there. But think that those books are there up to your fascination, just like you are taking your lunch. Something like good curries and good rice and dal, palau, rice and like that. But similarly, lunch is a lunch. Similarly, your reading book is that, as per your fascination, you have to take spiritual book. Well and good, it's the best. Second is that social books like novels and other things, that is also best. And crime stories, okay, thrilling. You can get thrills out of that, like that. But a regular practice of reading books is very, very essential in anybody's life. That creates two things. One is the knowledge, inner knowledge, then provoke your thought capability to greater height, to much deeper you can go in your thinking process. Third is your memory. Someone will ask you, have you read this book? Oh yes, I have read. So you can narrate. If you can narrate, that express your great capability of your own memory, that how much you have memorized. But in school book, today your teacher has told you and you forgot. You can read a book and you can memorize an entire book, but you cannot need. This is a level of interest. And level of practice. If you practice it for one day, nothing will be done. If you regularly go to library or keep some books and fix your time from every day, make a schedule of this thing and read. Whether your study books, in a service life, whether in novels or spiritual books like that, or any other book, thrillers like that, you can do. But prime aspect is that keep some time in your life, regular practice. If it is habituated into your blood that every day you must read something, and its cousin sister is to write something. I missed most of it. At this age, I am thinking to write something, to speak something. But if I would have done that from early stage, you see, I could have been a bigger writer. I could have been a bigger speaker or a capable speaker like that. But I couldn't be. Basically, I am shy, sober, and other things. Okay, this is an escapist attitude. It is not actually in true sense good thing. Good thing is that as a human being, whether it is a man, whether it is a woman, you have to develop your capability to how to speak beautifully and how to express beautifully. Every aspect of human being, every aspect of the society, and without daily practice, you will fail to express. You will be blanketed. Alibis you will give, bluffing you will do, but you cannot do anything unless you read books. It is the cousin sister. You read the book, you will gain the knowledge. Vast knowledge base will be there, and get it's reflected automatically in the mind, and in the canvas you can see the very good picture, and you can describe it, minute details, all these things eloquently. without any stop to everybody. So daily practicing of reading books, daily practicing of writing few pages and speaking if possible, not to air. My point is that nowadays, you see, I am talking to a video camera. You don't have. Okay, 2,000, 3,000 rupees, you can have a pen drive of a video voice recorder. You can talk to voice recorder. 46 hours, 30 hours, 22 hours, 20 hours, 48 hours, 16 hours, like that, it can be there, and pen drive is there. You can take a chip, 2T is there, 4T is there, and 2GB is there, 4GB is there, 16GB is there. You can pack it up all your speeches. If possible, you can write down into textbook and print it in a book. You may laugh at me. But thing is that creativity is the essential aspect of every human being. I have most of my life, and also many people, they now never realize even regular practice of writing, regular practice of speaking, regular practice of painting. Also, some people are very good at hand and creativity, like paintings, music, express, like that. And unfortunate situation has happened. My son, who is an advocate, senior advocate in Orissa High Court, he passed in graduation, post-graduation in guitar. Very beautiful he played over guitar, but violin, sorry. He played on violin, but what happened? One day he got a minor motorcycle accident, and his bone, this bone actually cracked. And after that, actually he couldn't play violin very nicely, and he stopped that. This is the most unfortunate aspect. Suppose, forget about things, but thing is that these are the mishappenings of a few cases. But on general aspect, if you know how to play music, please do. One of my friend is there who used to play very nice mouth organ, and till date, as far as my age is concerned, he used to play and most of the things. Another guy, he used to dance, and till date he is dancing along with his wife wherever the opportunity comes. Now point is that expressive attitude of a human being portrays actually your justification of existence in this world. And who is a good writer, who is a good speaker. Now you see, most of the people who are All India famous, they are because of this. They could write actually excellent, and they could speak excellent, like that. Like this happens. So these are the two major aspects. Third is that meditation. I have met nowadays that very tiny age people are attracted towards sitting coolly, meditating, and going to temples. They are silently standing, not talking to anybody, but only to looking to the idol. Have you seen? Once or twice I had seen, but never realized that such guys are there. But thing is that they can totally say entire Bhagavad Gita from their mouth. I got astonished as to how they remember. It is only because of regular practice. If you do this regular practice, today you take one stanza, next day one stanza, next day one stanza, 2 years, entire data is finished. No, 365 days, and I think 400 is their total stanza. 500 is Arjuna, Dhritarashtra, Sanjaya. If you add up, this is 500. 500 is 365. Already 400, say, most of the Gita will be there, and next year it will be over. But my point is that one stanza, if you say, In the morning you have read, in the evening you have read. One Bhagavad Gita are you doing? No, I am doing, but thing is that not regularly. I am saying so much, giving a presentation of this thing, but thing is that I am not doing myself. Doing is very, very good for Bhagavad Gita. If you read every day, it gives a lot of in-depth knowledge. Not only that, your capability and prowess, power to see actually in the true sense what is this life, human life is concerned, number one. Number two is that your objective of life. This is the number two. These two points will be very, very clear if you go. Mahatma Gandhi was one of the person who totally followed this thing, and Muslim. One thing I will tell you, Bahadur Shah Jafar entirely wrote, and his eldest son was totally singing entire Bhagavad Gita out of his mouth. Not only his son Dara, and not only he himself converted, translated from Sanskrit to Urdu, Bahadur Shah Jafar, the last Mughal of the empire. And not only these two, Abdul Kalam, our last president, late president, and he also used to sing entire Bhagavad Gita from his own mouth. We should feel ashamed. Being Hindu, we never, because we lack regular practice. And it is not a very difficult thing. Regular practice is not there. So spirituality is one of the aspects, meditation and silence, ethics. And the last chapter, I want to tell you friends, what is the ethics of a human being? You just choose actually what should be the topic for every human being. What you should do? You should be angry always, or you should be cool. I particularly myself, I was always angry, even little till latest. I am very, very angry at times, rest of the time very cool. But thing is that whenever I get angry, I lose my stability, I lose my tension, and lot of gastritis and acidity will burn within myself, not yourself. So the anger is, controlling anger is one of the major aspects. And second is that greedy, jealousy and all these the negative, you see, Kaurava. Kuru, 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 like that in the Mahabharata, if you read this thing, Kuru, 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 one is the repeatedly, they will come, rise up, then you demolish them, then again they will sprang up within from another corner, like that. They, like demons, they will sprang up out of nowhere. And you will be surprised that, okay, I will not be greedy. Let him have his five-storied building and four cars and it will never. But suddenly you will go another two step forward in a road. Eh? So much of road, so much of building, so much of plantation, so much of garden, so many people are working. Your jealousy is again burning. How many you will subside these things? So these are the Kauravas. Negative attitude. It is not daily practice. Arjuna tells her, how sir, Sakha, how will control itself? Say, he is telling, Sri Krishna is telling that, okay, this is only the trade secret is only that regular practice. If you regularly practice to suppress this thing, after 10 years or 20 years or 30 years, it will be totally eradicated, and you see that entire array of negative qualities like anger, jealousy, greed, lust, and whatever, so many things are there. There are 100 brothers. All will be demolished. And what are there? There are Panchupandava. There are 5 good natures, attributes like innocence, compassion, love, kindness, like that. All these things are very essential aspect of human being that actually lead into the light. Lead into the light means once you regularly practice, it is not very, very easily obtained. You see, if you want to be angry, immediately you will acquire this bad quality. But if you want to suppress it, it will take a lifetime. Till that I am fighting, but I cannot repress it. So those are such a devilish type of characters within us. And good nature to generate will be very, very difficult. But once they came, it never go. It never go. You are innocent guy lifelong, it will remain lifelong. Tomorrow you are yesteryears, you are innocent. Tomorrow you cannot be egoistic. You are as innocent then and as innocent as of now. Also, that is true. If you are kind enough, compassionate and loving at your teenage, you will be loving, compassionate under any circumstances, maybe depressed for a certain time, but it will sprang up and prevail entire life till your last day. And if you don't have it, try to develop, it will come very, very difficult time with regular practice, and once it will come, it will normalize your system as a divine quality. We call as then divine. This demonic, what? This anger, jealousy, greedy, lust, and all this temptation, all these things are demonic qualities in every human being. But these are divine qualities. The divine qualities also regular practice that we achieve in the life. Basically, those things are we are using regular meditation. At present, I am telling you, at the fag end of my life, I used to do regular practice of meditation and regular practice of being silence. Twist your tongue, remain silent, you cannot talk mostly. And if you want, I want to talk to you, I am telling for an hour or so, or half an hour or so, but after that I will never bother about this thing, I will remain silent, right? Then the silence actually brings actually capability, your ability to move deep within. And if you see, go to a closed chamber, dark room, sit somewhere. I am not talking about spirituality. Sit somewhere, close your eyes and think, try to think nothing. Simply think and watch your breath. If you are getting bored, then watch your breath. Coming in, going out, coming in, going out, coming in, going out. If you want still get bored, then link to a name that you love. Jesus, 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 Allah, 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 Narayan, Narayan, Narayan. Like that. If you connect it to this God, I love, I love, I love, I love. Like that. If you don't want anything, then simply watch the breath. Best thing is this, simply watch the breath. And sit hour for hour, round. So. Gradually one hand, as Swami Siddhananda said, once this close your eyes, this is an empty chamber, dark empty chamber. And this dark chamber, you will see that you are sitting. Not outside, within, you are sitting in a dark chamber. Okay, so there what will happen? If you maintain silence and throughout the time you enter, you see, now for half an hour you will become silence, it will not be. Your mental is totally disturbed, it cannot be doused immediately. It will take some time. Or automatically it takes some time. Entire day you are silent, so automatically you are aloof, not mixing with friends, not going visiting places and other things, quietly reading some books or contemplating like that way. Or sitting even TV also, looking anything, but TV is running. But you are sitting there, watching your breath. You can do excellent way, regular practice. But by that way, when you sit in a dark chamber, eyes closed, slow breathing, and at that time, In silence, you will see your mind, in silence, try to go deeper within. And where you will go? You cannot see anything. It is totally dark. And at that time, you see, there is another faculty called intuition. That intuition will take you, dive yourself, give ability to dive yourself deep within. As if in a dark water, you are driving or diving within. And you don't know where you are going, but deep within. Then intuition will take you there. And instinctively guide you from this place to that place, to that place, to that place, like that, within the dark chamber, without in a total absence of thought, and in deep silence, totally alone, seclusion. If you see it, how many points I have told? Number one, alone. Number two, silence. Third is dark chamber. Fourth is, but closing your eyes and blocking your thoughts, not possible. Regular practice, it will be possible. Now, what I have most in my life? Missed most in my life is regular practice. This regular practice, if you do, then you can able to block your thought. Otherwise, after few minutes, you will think that you are thinking. You are not sitting alone. Somebody is within your brain, involving with you. So that is the thing, that without blocking your thought, these are the aspects if you maintain, then instinct will, intuition will guide you, and instinct will change your direction pattern of one point to the next point, to the next point, to the next point, like that. And you will see, if you see, sometimes very few people feel their eyeball is also moving. But actually, if you are totally on trance, that will eyeball never moves. Then you can practice also, regularize, take a lamp. Swami Sivananda said that take a lamp and look. Eyeball will not drop. And look, in my front, I will show you, you see, that is a, mother. I used to give mother's picture. So I always, I prefer actually sitting and look her, to her picture. And near my bed there is my Gurudev Paramahansa Pragyananda picture. I used to look to him and look for an hour. That will give your concentration. So if you look, closing your eyes, you see, look to this place. Even closing your eyes, you can look. Remember, you can look. You can look here. You can look here. You can look here. When you look top, looked up, you see your eyeball is up. When you look to the tip of the nose, your eyeball will be slightly down. Will be looking to the in-between point of the eyebrows, you'll be eyebrows will be straight at the most convenient place. And you sit there and think, sit for hours. Today it is 15 minutes, next day it will be half an hour, next day it will be 1 hour. After a decade, tell me. I may not be there. But after a decade, you will see wonderful things happening to you. There will be no light. There will be totally darkness will be removed. And a pointed blazing light, as bright as sun, you can find in IIT, I have found out. Where this blazing light is coming? So, practice, regular practice that I have mostly missed in my life is that now at the last point of my talk is that regularity is not a brushing your teeth, regularity is not your taking your food in time, regularity of concentration, regularity of reading books, regularity pilgrimages or visiting very good places and enlightening your life style, other things, regularity of putting new dresses and putting cigarette or taking beetles and all these toxic things, no poisons, no debris, and developing your negative attitudes or eliminating your negative attitude and developing your divine qualities. I am not my point today. Presentation, main topic that I am to present, and the last fag end of light to instill in your mind this question: have I done in my life? What is my age? 24. Oh, I am not late. Let us start what this man is telling. Sit in a dark chamber, see, close your eyes, never think anything, turn your tongue, maintain silence, and watch your breath or link with a name as before, so that you will not getting bored. 10 to 15, half an hour, 1 hour, 10 hour, breathing is going on like that, breathe like that, and a day will come in your light. And the light that will give, the intuition will be led by instinct. And where there is instinct will lead to the point, there will be illusion. And once the illusion comes, the entire room where you are sitting will be lighted. Once lighted, you can see all the details in that room. What you want, what do you think that you can see? You can see only this thing, yourself. There are on four direction, there are four mirrors, there are four image of yourself only. That is a mirror image. No, your own aspect or attributes you can see. Once you see, you start judging yourself, not actually commenting on others, not about commenting on the world, but commenting on yourself. Okay, I have done that, gone astray there, I will control myself. You will a better human being like sir. Okay sir, today I complete, let me complete my talk. What I have missed most of my life, regular practice I have missed, but still then I am practicing. Whatever I think, I am doing. So at times reading some books, at times writing some books, at times speaking something, at times seeing in Facebook and writing something, whatever is possible. And daily practices, as I have told you, all past part of the my topic, like daily exercises and regular practices of daily exercise, morning like dusk and from dawn to dusk, like that I have to do. My request is that whoever at the even ripe age also, still better late than never. Practicing regularity of practices helps you to alleviate from your problems and to draw you as a better human being in life and in your lifetime also. Thank you very much. I express again my best wishes to you, sir. And pray for all of you a very happy, new, prosperous year. And bring immense happiness and health for all of you and in your families also. Thank you.